Hello, I'm Robin Worley, welcome to LensCraft. Today, I want to explain how you can add Photoshop plugins to Affinity Photo. This is much easier than you might think, and you probably won't need to reinstall the plugins to do this. The tricky part is knowing where the plugins are installed on your computer, because there are a few possible locations. I'll explain where to look on both a PC and a Mac later in this video. If you read the Affinity Photo help documentation, it says that Photoshop compatible 64-bit plugins can be used in Affinity. Whilst this is true, not every Photoshop plugin will work. This means some of the plugins will fail, whilst some may exhibit odd behaviour. We'll look at a few examples later in this video. Despite there being some problems though, it's still worth checking all your plugins by running them in Affinity. If we look in Affinity Photo, under the Filters menu, you can see the Plugins submenu. This is where any installed plugins appear. But because the Photoshop plugins are installed to my Photoshop folder on my computer, Affinity won't detect them there. We can see what's happening if we open the Affinity Photo preferences. If you're using a Mac like I am, you'll find the preferences under the Affinity Photo menu. On a Windows PC, they're in the Edit menu. This opens the Preferences dialog where you can select the Photoshop plugins option. There are several parts to this dialog that you need to be aware of, and the Mac version is slightly different in layout because there's an additional step you need to do. Top left is a button to open the default plugin location for Affinity Photo. When I click this, Affinity opens a Finder window, which is the Mac equivalent of Windows File Explorer. This is where to install your plugins if you want Affinity to automatically recognize them. Currently, I don't have any plugins in this folder, which is why there aren't any in my plugins menu. When Affinity detects plugins, they're listed in this table. If, like me, your plugins are installed to Photoshop, you probably don't want to reinstall them again to add them to Affinity. The solution is to let Affinity know where your Photoshop plugins are installed using this Add button. Be sure that you're using the top section to do this and not the lower Add button. If you're using a Windows PC, the layout looks slightly different and you only have the single Add button. When I click the Add button, I can select the folder where the Photoshop plugins are installed. Now, before you use this, it's important to understand where your plugins are installed because it's easy to get into a mess. Even if you have a Windows PC, don't skip ahead because you'll miss some important points. The Photoshop plugin files you need are held in an Adobe folder called Plugins, and the location depends on a few things, including your version of Photoshop. In older versions of Photoshop, you'll find the Plugins folder in the Applications area. When I look in my Mac's application folder, I can see four Adobe Photoshop folders. I currently have Photoshop 2020 and 2021 installed on this Mac, but I still have folders from 2018 and 2019. That's because Photoshop leaves behind third-party assets, including plugins, when it's uninstalled. If we look in the 2018 folder, we see a plugins folder, and in there are all the plugin files I had installed to that version of Photoshop. Now, if we look at the plugins folder of 2019 version, we don't see the same plugins. That's because Adobe changed the structure of where things are stored when they release Photoshop 2019. This means you could have your plugins spread across different locations depending on when they were installed. You might also find you have different versions of the same plugin installed in different locations. If we look at the 2018 plugin folder, we can see the Google version of the Nik collection there. But in fact, I have the latest version of the Nik collection from DxO, which is installed elsewhere. What this means is that you need to find the correct version of each plugin so that you can add the location to Affinity. If your version of Photoshop is 2018 or older, the plugins are probably in your application files. But there's something else I want to show you. If we look in my Photoshop application folders, we see the Silverfast 9 import plugin. This is the latest version of the Silverfast scanning plugin, which was released only a few weeks ago. When I installed Silverfast to my computer, it installed the plugin to every Photoshop plugin folder. This means you may still need to check these folders even if you have a recent version of Photoshop. Now let's look at the other plugin location on the Mac, which Adobe started to use from Photoshop 2019. You'll find this in the Library folder, where you'll see a folder called Application Support. In there, you'll find an Adobe folder, and in that, you'll see lots of folders for saved assets, including plugins. If we look in the Plugins folder, you'll see a CC folder, which is where we find all the plugin files. But notice, the Silverfast plugin I mentioned earlier isn't installed here. If I want access to that plugin from Affinity, I need to add the Other Plugin folder. The other point I want to highlight is that we see my current DxO version of the Nick collection installed here. This means that if I add this plugin folder and my plugin folder from Photoshop 2018, I can end up with two versions of the plugin, which could get very confusing. That's why it's important to do this initial check to find where all your plugins are. I'm now going to add the CC folder from the Library section. We can see this added to the plugins search folder. Affinity will then search this folder as well as its default folder to find any installed plugins. I'll also add the application plugin folder where we saw the Silverfast plugin installed. I can now close the plugins preference dialog and I'm prompted to restart Affinity. If I don't restart Affinity, I won't see the Photoshop plugins. Once Affinity Photo restarts, all the Photoshop plugins are listed. At this point, I want to share the location of the plugin folder on the Windows PC. In the Windows File Explorer, find the Program Files directory. This is the disk where you have the Windows operating system installed, and it's usually the C drive. In there, you'll find an Adobe folder, which has the Photoshop application folder, where you'll find the older plugins folder. This is just like the application folder we looked at on the Mac. The new plugin folder, though, is found in the program folder still, but in a folder called Common Files. Here, you'll find an Adobe folder, and in that is the plugin folder. If you check that folder, you'll find the CC folder with all the plugins. Now don't worry about writing all this down, I'll include these paths in the YouTube video information. The other difference I want to point out on a Windows PC is for anyone using the older 32-bit version of Photoshop. You'll find those files in the Program Files x86 folder, where the folder structure is very similar to what we've just discussed. The problem you may face, though, is that these are the older 32-bit plugins and probably aren't compatible with Affinity Photo. Now let's get back to the plugin preferences on my Mac, because Mac owners still have an additional step. When I scroll down the list of plugins, I can see that some have Requires Global Support next to them in red. What these plugins need is the ability to access resources in other locations on my computer before they'll work. The way I can do this is using the Authorize Global button. I can now select the root location of my Mac's hard drive. Once I've authorized this, you can see that the problem plugins now show as being working. I then need to restart Affinity Photo as I did before. Having restarted Affinity Photo, I can close the Preferences dialog and we can try some of the plugins. I'll start by opening an image and then duplicating the background to a new layer in order to test the plugins. When I look in the plugins menu, I can see all the detected Photoshop plugins. I'll start by selecting Nick Viveza from the Nick collection, as this should be a compatible plugin for Affinity Photo. Everything looks fine with this, so let's now look at a few other options, because not every plugin will work with Affinity. If we look at the list of the plugins, first notice that the Silverfast plugin is missing. In Photoshop, the Silverfast plugin is accessed from the File Import menu and is used to capture an image from a scanner. I don't believe there's an equivalent feature to this in Affinity, so the plugin is missing. Let's now test the Exposure X6 plugin. When I try to launch this, nothing happens. This may be the same for other plugins as well. Some of them may not launch, some of them may be greyed out, and some might even cause Affinity to crash. If that happens, don't worry, just restart Affinity and try the next plugin. Now, one plugin that behaves rather unusually is On1. The plugin launches, but the first time you try it, you just see a browser window filled with thumbnails. you don't see the image you're wanting to edit. Then, if you close this and try it a second time, it works and we can edit the image. You can then continue to launch the On1 plugin with other images and it seems to work. The false start only seems to happen the first time you launch On1 after restarting your computer. Now, this may not be the same on your computer, but I wanted to mention this because it can trick you into thinking that you can't use On1 with Affinity Photo when in fact you can. We've covered a lot of ground in today's video, and some of this has been quite technical. As I mentioned earlier, I'll include the paths to the plugin folders in the YouTube video description. I'll also be publishing a written tutorial on my LensCraft website with this information. Once it's ready, I'll also include a link to that tutorial in this YouTube video information. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have, please share it with other Affinity Photo users. I'm Robin Worley, you've been watching LensCraft, I'll see you soon for another video.